So.
So you want.
So you want the fight, although we run close tonight. Look like the first player we killed was any moment or not.
Yeah, obviously. We had a good start there. Jeremy Ellis won his first shorthanded goal. We talked about keeping the puck out of the middle, and the turnovers kind of killed us tonight. I mean, you throw pass up, you know, against Coventry, they're just going to turn you over and come down. And, you know, the shooters they have over there, you can't give them time and space. And they buried a couple of nice goals there. Bush couldn't see in the second one. You know, but you give those guys space, the Fulghums and, you know, all those shooters they got over there, and you know, they bury them. You make mistakes, they put it in the back of your goal. And second period, Bush made some nice saves for us, a couple breakaways there, and gave us a chance to win tonight. Our power play didn't do much tonight, and that's what the game was all about. Like first period turnovers, and our special team wasn't there. So
it started to look like there was a couple of passes, some inside passes as we call them, across the. Defensive zone that killed us in the first period. How are we going to try to eradicate that one?
Well, we talk about it every week, and you know, it seems like the same guys make the same mistakes. We say if you got nowhere to go, you can't make a play, go off the wall and get it out. There's no need to go through the middle, and it's been killing us the last few games. And you know, we played well on Wednesday, got a big win, and you know, we played well for 40 minutes. I mean, you can't take that away. That's a team that's won 12 games in a row here in the league. We battled with them right till the end.
Yeah, it certainly looked like the last 20 minutes, we was all over them, especially the last 15 minutes. I know there was a couple of power players amongst there, but we did seem a lot more busier in the third period, which really annoys the fans, really, because we should have done that in the first and second period.
Yeah, Jager made some nice saves. I mean, you got to give him credit. He put a wall up, and you know, we had some chances, and it just didn't want to go in tonight. You got to give him credit. He played well, and now we got to refocus and get ready for Wednesday, our league game Wednesday. Tomorrow we have the Challenge Cup game, and we'll go there and battle tomorrow night.
Are you going to take tomorrow any difference than you did tonight because it's the Challenge Cup game?
Well, obviously we're not going to roll over because we're out of the Challenge Cup. We're going to go there and work hard, and obviously we'll give some young guys more ice time, and maybe rest some of the older guys, and we want to be fresh for Wednesday. Wednesday's a big league game in Sheffield, and you know, I haven't decided. Maybe Jazzy are going to start tomorrow night, and we'll decide tomorrow the game.
So it's a role five defenseman tonight. Grundman has got a bit more ice time than he has been in the last couple of weeks. Can you enlighten us on that one?
Yeah, I mean, Grundy's a young player. You know, he's got a lot of potential. The last few games he wasn't willing to battle. There's other guys that were willing to battle, but he can't catch everything. I mean, it's up to myself and the bench coach on the bench there to tell me who's, because I can't see everything all the time. And yeah, Grundy's made a few mistakes, but he played better tonight, and that was nice to see.
Once again, another standout performance from Andrew Corbett.
Yeah, I mean, Andrew just comes to play every night. He keeps everything simple. And, that's all you can ask. I mean, you want everyone to play simple. And Andrew does that. Like I said last time, he's been well coached in college, and he's come over and he's done a great job for us.
The team didn't seem as busy as they did on Wednesday from the fans' point of view. Especially the first final, it was really busy on the fair against Brayhead on Wednesday. Is that because Coventry were a better team, or is it just because they just took the foot off a bit?
Yeah, I mean, obviously Coventry is a better team than Brayhead, but I mean, we believe we have a chance every night to win hockey games. So, you know, we respect every team we play. It doesn't matter who it is, Dundee, Brayhead, Nottingham. We're going to play the same way. And we had our chances tonight. We just didn't put it in the back of the net. Obviously, we need some of our goal scorers to get going and score some big goals for us. And we need them to step up against big teams.
Seems to have changed the lines around a little bit tonight. Especially in the third period, it looked like the lines were a bit changed. Was that a conscious decision?
Yeah, let's try to switch things up and get some guys going. I mean, A couple guys have been playing together since day one, but they're not doing much right now. So you try to switch it up, and you know, try to throw Kelmy with Mitch. I know how hard Mitch works and can get him the puck and maybe open things up for Kelmy, and switch UC around and Tendler and Davies. But you know what, we got to bury our chances, and we didn't do that tonight.
Certainly missing Jason Silva for the minute. Is there any news on when Jason's going to be back in the lineup?
Yeah, obviously we missed Silver, so. You know, he was our top player there since day one, and once we get him back in the lineup, he'll be a big plus. I mean, the speed he brings to our team, and you know, he's a key guy we're missing. Also, we're missing Laker. I mean, Laker's our spark plug, and you know, we miss him big time out there. And then you got a little Mitch on defense that just got his cast off, so it'll be nice to get him back too. It'll make us stronger defensively, and you know, once we get our full lineup back. You know, there's no excuses. I mean, there's no excuses right now. I'm sure we could win games Wednesday with guys out of the lineup. So we'll go from there. It'll be a bonus once we get all those guys back.
If any Newsons was out there tonight, I wouldn't have thought that there was such a big difference between the two teams in position-wise in the league. We only got beat 3-1 and we did run them close. What do you think is the main difference between us and Coventry at the minute?
Well, obviously, the experience they have over there, they have a lot of experience, a lot of guys have won championships, and you know, you can't take that away. We got a young team, and it's a learning curve every night, and we're going to keep cutting away, and hopefully we can steal some points from them.
Right, once again, we'll go back on today, all night and up, so have we got any more news on Mustache Gate?
No, well, right, we played our mustache game. Neighbor is the one wearing a mustache right now, so next month it'll be a new guy. So we're just having fun with it. Neighbor has been a good sport.
Why'd you get your hair cut?
Hey! Well, once again, I'd like to thank Sylvain for coming to the Postmarks interview. Once again, thanks a lot, Sylvain.
Thank you.